Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build a 1-wide and a 2-wide floor block slipper that can be extended infinitely. And those are the two versions here. One, as you can see, with a single file of glowstone blocks that can be swept out, in this case with iron blocks. And here we have our double line of blocks that get swept out. And as you can see, it's a rather fast mechanism. And also rather lag-friendly by using those observers here. So very nice and quite useful for decorating your base. So anyway, that's the general use of it. Now let's quickly talk about the size of it. As you can see, it's a modular design with a control circuit, in both cases of course. The modules are only one block long, so each strip of this one here is one module. They are more or less independent, although one module triggers the next module, of course, but otherwise they don't influence each other. So then, as you can see, for the 1-wide version, the entire thing is 5 blocks wide and 5 blocks high. The 2-wide version is also 5 blocks high, but a total of 10 blocks wide. The control circuits are for the 1-wide version also 5 blocks long, 3 blocks long and 5 blocks high. And for the 2-block version, it's 5 blocks high, 10 blocks wide and 2 blocks long. So a bit shorter than the 1-wide version, due to the simple fact that it has more space available for the redstone components. So, and while we're talking about those, let's quickly get to the required resources. For the 1-wide version, you will need for the control circuit 12 normal blocks, then 7 redstone dust, 5 redstone repeaters, 3 observers, 3 normal pistons and 1 sticky piston, and some kind of input represented by this lever. And then for each module you will need the 2 blocks that get swept out, then 6 observers, 2 normal pistons and 1 sticky piston. So the modules themselves are actually rather cheap and also easy to build, as you will see later on. Now for the 2-wide version, again for the control circuit you will need, in this case, 16 normal blocks, 8 redstone dust, 1 redstone torch, 4 redstone repeaters, 3 observers, 2 pistons and 2 sticky pistons, and then again a lever or another kind of input. And then for each module you will need 2 normal blocks, then the blocks to swap out, 10 observers, 4 normal pistons and 2 sticky pistons. So as you can see, it's getting a bit more expensive, but that is kind of what you would expect. So anyway, that's essentially all you're gonna need to know, so let's quickly show you how to build those 2 block slippers here. Okay, so now for the 1-wide version. The first step is actually building the very first module, like here. So this is the block that gets swept out later on with this block here on the side. And the layout is pretty simple. At the bottom we have later on a chain of, or 3 chains of observers going away from the control circuit we will build in a moment. Then going upwards, again observers, and those are powering a sticky piston in the middle, and non-sticky pistons on either side, and in between then are just the blocks to be swept out. So that's the general layout. Now, after you have built the first module, let's go down here and start on this side where the block is essentially raised at the moment. And let's start by placing 5 blocks, as you can see here. Now place a repeater on 3 ticks here and 1 on 1 tick there. Redstone on top of those blocks, a piston in this direction, then normal block on top of this redstone, an observer facing downwards like so, with redstone on top, and redstone there, then block here, with a repeater in this direction on 2 ticks. Now let's go down here, place another 3 blocks like that, with redstone dust there, and 2 repeaters here, 1 on 4 ticks, 1 on 2 ticks, like that. Finally, let's place another non-sticky piston there with a block right in front of it. And then let's get to this side here, a sticky piston there with block on top, block to this side, redstone top of this block, block here to cut off that wire, then observer up in this direction and towards the back here, and finally a non-sticky piston right besides this block here. And that's all. And this line here is essentially our input line, so let's quickly put a block up here and power the entire thing. And as you can see, that's the one white version completely built. And after that, the next step is then of course copying this layer or layout here over until you have the length you want. And you should end up with something like this. So very simple, very straightforward. Now one thing you can actually modify in this thing here is that you can replace this chain of observers down here with a line of redstone, possibly with repeaters when you reach 15 blocks length. This will then mean that the modules are not powered one after the other, but all at the same time. The downside to this is that you produce more lag in total. And it's also one block deeper going below the floor, since you need some blocks to place the redstone on top. But it's still an option for this one. So now for the two-byte version, it's again a good idea to start building the very first module before the control circuit. And in this case, those two blocks here are the blocks or the position where the blocks end in. And those two blocks down here are the blocks, those here are swapped out later on. The general layout is pretty simple, as you can see here. On one side we have a block, an observer going towards the back, then one up and one to the side. So a very simple construction here. So back, up and inside, then just a block and two non-sticky pistons on top. The same thing is true for the other side. And here we just have the observer back and up and then the non-sticky piston on top. So very simple, very straightforward. And as I already mentioned, those are the blocks that are at the moment in the end position. So now let's start with the control circuit. First place a temporary block here, then a sticky piston directly like that, and non-sticky piston I mean. Then place normal blocks right in front of the observers down here. Note those blocks should be retracted, which is rather important for the next step, which is placing observers in this direction here and here. If those were still extended, we would have kind of confused the circuitry and would have to replace them. So next, let's go on this side and place a repeater on three ticks there, then a sticky piston upwards here with a block there, then two blocks like that, redstone on top, then observer down here. It should now power this redstone line right next to the piston there. Then let's go here and first three blocks back like so. A non-sticky piston again like that. Then place a block here with redstone on top. And now place three blocks in a shape like that. Then one repeater on four ticks here, another one on two ticks there. Next, let's grab some redstone and place it on top of this block here. Then let's quickly place a repeater on two ticks here. Sticky piston there, block on top, then two more blocks like so. Redstone on top of this block here, then another block there with a torch to the side. Again, block here and redstone there. And that's almost everything done. So now we will have to actually remove those blocks and put them in the end position. And that's the entire thing actually finished. So now everything works. And the next step then, of course, is actually copying this module over and over until you reach the length you want. And we are finished. So now this is the final product. As you can see, it works perfectly like it's supposed to. And of course, this line here is our input line. Just make sure that the redstone goes into this block and in this block here and does not get redirected when you try to power it. So either power this block directly with a repeater, for example, or run a line of redstone in this block here. But besides of that, again, here is one little modification you can do, and that is replacing those chains of observers at the bottom here with a redstone line, or in this case a double line here, which then would mean that all of the modules would trigger at the same time and not in sequence, like here. The downside again to this is an increased lag, and of course in the middle one block extra depth for the blocks where the redstone is on top. But anyway, that was how you can build the 1-byte and 2-byte versions of my infinitely expandable block swappers. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!